Okay, I'm here with one half of Outkast, Andre3000.
Yes.
Dude, how you going?
Hey, I'm fine. How about yourself?
I'm going very well.
Good.
Now, where's Big Boy?
Big Boy's in America.
What's
right
he doing?
Now. He's doing promotion in America.
Okay.
For our new single, Roses.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice. Now, your new album, Speakerboxx, The Love Below.
Mm-hmm.
It's a dual solo album. What made you want to do that?
The Love Below was originally a solo album, and it was supposed to be the soundtrack to a movie that myself and Brian Barber, video director, we were writing.
Mm-hmm.
And at the last minute, we decided that it may not be a good time to drop a solo album. So the record company says, well, I don't know if you should drop a solo album. And so Big Boy goes in and records Speakerboxx, and we put it together and called it the Outkast album.
Right. Now, what's this film? What was the movie?
The Love Below was a love story, so if you listen to the album, you can hear a little story in it, and we'll probably revisit that story in some form. I don't know how we're going to do it just yet, but right now we're working on an HBO movie, and
Speakerboxx? Is that what it's called?
We don't know just yet. It may be called Speakerboxx, but it's going to be starring myself and Big Boy, and they're going to use songs from both albums, but there'll be an original soundtrack with completely new songs.
And that's going to be your next album,
isn't
it?
The next Outkast album. You've been doing some
work. I have, mate.
All right, mate.
Don't give me grief. Anyway, now The Love Below, it's quite different from your previous albums. It's gone a bit jazzy, quite a bit experimental, if you will. How did you think your fans were going to react to it?
I didn't know.
No. You a little bit worried?
Yes, I was worried.
Yeah.
I didn't know. Not to say I didn't care, but I couldn't have done anything else though. You know, it was. I just had to put it out. You know.
Nice. Was it to do with maybe just like because you guys have been together since you're in high school?
Right. 10th grade.
Yeah. Wow. That's true. There you go. And was it time to just have a bit of a break? Was that why you sort of did a little solo project, or?
I think the time, we've been together for like 11 years professionally. But more or less, you know, time to take a break. I think just as individuals, we were going off to do things, you know, being that I would produce and write songs, I started writing these songs where they were full singing compositions, you know, just melody, it wasn't really rhyming. And so people know us for rhyming more. And so, that's the reason why The Love Below was a solo project, because it was that. And Big Boy is on, Roses is the only song that Big Boy is on The Love Below. But even Roses still fits into the original story theme, you know.
Yes, now, The Love Below is a lot to do with relationships and love. Did you write from your own experiences?
Yes, about 80% from my own experiences, and some, you know, made up just to make the story cool. Like the whole Roses song was just made up, you know. I don't know anybody named Caroline.
There's not anybody with an alias name.
Exactly, but I know people like Caroline.
Right.
Yes.
Now, Outkast won the first ever best album hip hop act. Let me say that again. Okay. Outkast was the first ever hip-hop act to win Best Album for a Grammy. Why do you think it took so long for a hip-hop act to actually win Best Album?
Good question. I don't know.
No?
No.
Why do you think you
were... To me, there's been a lot of great hip-hop albums.
Yeah.
But see, I think when you say Album of the Year, that means overall. In music, period, you know?
Yeah.
And so I don't know if hip-hop albums in their earlier days, if they were, I guess, if their music, you know, just spread, you know, I think it was just too concentrated, you know, to win Album of the Year, but I don't know.
Got you stumped.
So what's your favorite food?
I don't have one anymore.
No?
No, I like all sorts.
Alright, cool.
What's yours?
Broccoli.
Really?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
That's so odd.
No. I'm a vegetarian.
Oh. Well, there you go. That makes sense. Do you like Brussels sprouts?
No.
I don't know anyone who does. Anyway, now you're going to be starring as Jimi Hendrix in an upcoming biopic. Did I say that right? Biopic?
Yes, you did.
I did. Good. Coming up very soon. Just for the, we do like young little kids out there, they probably don't know who Jimi Hendrix is.
Really?
So, yeah.
You don't know who Jimi Hendrix is?
Well, they might,
is.
But some of them might not. Just tell us a bit about the movie. And
well, actually, I can tell you more about Jimi Hendrix in the movie.
Okay, go on.
Because right now, there's not, I guess the movie is in pre-production right now, and we're trying to work out the deal. So there's a great possibility that I will be playing it, but it's not for sure. Mm-hmm. I've been meeting with directors and producers and, you know, having meetings about it, and it's looking really good. But as far as like song rights, you know, and yeah, got issues like that, so who knows? But Jimi Hendrix, he's I think one of the best guitar players in the world. See, what you have is guitar players before Jimi Hendrix, and then you have guitar players after Jimi Hendrix. So everybody after Jimi Hendrix is pretty much influenced by Jimi Hendrix in some kind of way.
Yourself, were you?
Most definitely. And I'm a bad guitar player. I'm like the worst.
Really?
Yeah.
How long have you been playing?
How about 4 years.
Okay, so you've been playing.
And that's why I like punk guitar players, because they're not really good.
Do you ever thrash it out with a bit of punk?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Sweet.
Believe it or not.
Sweet. Start that over there.
All right.
Now, the movie that you and Big Boy are working on, which could be Speakerboxx.
Could be Speakerboxx.
Could be,
yes.
Speakerboxx. What soundtrack, because you're going to write the soundtrack, what can we expect from the sound? Is it going to be the same, you know, bit out there, or is it going to stick back to the hip-hop roots, or?
We don't know.
You don't know? Are you working on it?
Yes, we're working on it right now.
So you don't know?
No, I don't know.
No? You're not going to...
I can't go out on a limb. I can't give you that many hints.
Oh, damn it! Damn it! Alrighty, fair enough.
Because it changes, you know. We can have a plan and start with a couple of songs, and you're like, nah, that's not it, and do something else. If I tell you now, and then you're expecting something, and it may not be it, so I can't tell you.
But yeah, you're gonna try and be a bit more experimental. Like, you're still gonna.
Nah, we're just gonna try to have fun, pretty much.
Good philosophy.